Today we are going to learn an important subject of GATE exam, that is Electronic Devices and Circuits EDC. This subject carries around 4 to 6 marks in GATE exam out of 100, and also this subject is important as far as analog electronics is concerned, because most of the topics in analog electronics are based on the concepts of ADC. We will start our discussion with energy band diagram. An energy band diagram is the representation of energy levels of different type of charge carriers that are present in the material. Charge carriers are of two different types. One is electron and one is hole. Electrons in the material are of two types. One which can take part in conduction, means after applying supply to the material, electrons can move, that are called free electrons. And another type is bonded electron. Bonded electron means which are in covalent bonds, or any other, in case of metal, in metallic bond, bonded electrons which cannot move even if we have applied supply across the material. And another type of charge carrier is hole. These three charge carriers carry different energy, means these are at different energy levels, and representation of energy of these charge carriers is done through energy band diagram. An energy band diagram basically consists of three energy band, one called conduction band, one valence band, and an energy band which separates both conduction band and valence band called forbidden band. Conduction band means higher energy levels. Valence band matlab means lower energy level, and forbidden band separates these lower energy levels and higher energy level. If an electron is bonded, means that cannot move, is said to be present in valence band, means valence band represents energy of bonded electrons. If we want this electron to take part in conduction, we have to first move this electron from valence band to conduction band, means we have to break the covalent bond and make this electron as free electron. So now I can say that the energy of bonded electron lies in valence band, and the energy of free electrons lies in conduction band, means conduction band represents energy of free electrons present in the material, and valence band represent bonded electron present in the material. If this bonded electron is moved from valence band to conduction band, there will be a deficiency of electron which is called hole. This deficiency will remain in valence band itself. So now I can say that the valence band represent energy of holes present in the material. So there are three energy bands. First, conduction band. This conduction band represents energy of free electrons. Free electrons means the type of electrons which can move with when supply is given to the material. Number two, valence band represents represents energy of bonded electrons and holes in the material. Number 3, called forbidden band. Forbidden band is the separation between conduction band and valence band. If suppose any electron is present in valence band means an electron in valence band means it is a type of electron which cannot move even if supply is given. If this electron is if we want this electron to take part in conduction, we have to first move this electron from valence band to conduction band, and for this we have to supply some energy to the material. Energy is supplied in two form. Number one, we can increase temperature of the material, means surrounding temperature of the material. And number two, by making light to incident on the material. In these two form, we can supply energy to the material. If temperature is increased of the material, we can say that energy is being supplied to the material, and with this energy supplied, an electron will gain some energy, and if it is sufficient to break the bond in the material, this electron will break the bond and will move from valence band to conduction band and become free electron. And the deficiency of electron in the valence band is called hole. To move an electron from valence band to conduction band, we have to supply some energy, which is approximately this much. This energy band which separates valence band and conduction band called forbidden energy band, and the width of forbidden energy band EG represents the minimum energy required to be supplied in order to move an electron from valence band to conduction band. Now we will see energy band diagram for different materials. We will start with conductors, means metals. In case of metals, conduction takes place due to only electrons, means there are no holes in case of metals. Also, metal possess one property that the electron concentration, I'm talking about free electrons only, electron concentration is independent of temperature. Means if we are increasing temperature of the material or decreasing temperature of the material, it will not have any effect on electron concentration, means there is no bond breaking process in case of metals. So electron concentration will be same at 0 degrees Kelvin or at room temperature or at 100 degrees Celsius. At all the temperatures, the electron concentration will be same. So I can conclude that in case of metals, to make any electron free, I need not supply any energy. That is, in case of metal, conduction band and valence band are not separated by any forbidden energy band. That is, forbidden energy band gap Eg is equal to zero, and Eg is represented in electron volts, that energy of unit of energy electron volts. Eg equal to 0 electron volts for metals, means we need not supply any energy to the metal in order to obtain conduction from metal. Number two, semiconductors. Semiconductors are the materials which sometimes conduct, means depending on the surrounding condition, and sometimes do not conduct, behave as an insulator. In case of semiconductors, both electrons and holes take part in conduction, means there are electrons and as well holes are charge carriers in case of semiconductors. In case of semiconductors, if we change the surrounding temperature, means energy is supplied to the material, the electron and hole concentration, electron and hole concentration will change with temperature, means bonds will be broken and more number of electrons and holes will be generated with increase in temperature of the material. In case of semiconductors, the energy band diagram consists of all the three bands, that is conduction band, valence band, and a band which is separating both valence band and conduction band, called forbidden band. The lowest energy of conduction band is called energy level EC, and the highest energy of valence band is called EV, and this EV and EC are separated by forbidden energy band, whose width is represented by EG. For semiconductors, EG is not equal to 0 volt and it is around 1 electron volt at room temperature. At T equal to 0 degrees Kelvin, in case of semiconductors, T equal to 0 degrees Kelvin means no energy is supplied from the surrounding means material is not supplied with any energy from the surrounding, and in this case, in a semiconductor, all the electrons will be in bonds, that is bonded, and these bonded electrons will be present in valence band. If all the electrons are in valence band, there will be no electrons in conduction band, as there are no free electrons. I will say there are no electrons in conduction band, means conduction band is empty for semiconductors at